Hello and welcome. In this lesson, we're going over how to do long division with a two-digit divisor. It's definitely a lot more work than a one-digit divisor, and we'll answer this one example here. Don't stress out, we'll make sure we take it nice and slow. And if this video helps you, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any more of our videos. Coming up on the math review. So here's the example that we're going to do together. 6,657 divided by 21. As you can see, I have three different areas here. This first area I'm going to make for my steps. I'll leave this space for my long division, and this extra area over here is going to be for any extra work we need while we're doing calculations with our two-digit divisor. So let's start by putting our example in long division notation. In our standard notation, this first number is our dividend. So we'll put it inside of our long division notation. And notice how I left a lot of space between my numbers. That's incredibly important here. Make sure you do the same exact thing when you do your work. Next, we'll put our divisor, 21, outside of our long division notation. For steps, I like to write four simple letters. D, which stands for divide, M, which stands for multiply, S, which stands for subtract, and then B, which means to bring down. And I also like to put an arrow going back to the first letter in case we need to go back and repeat the process. You'll see that as we go through our example. Oh, and one more thing I love to tell my students to do before we actually start our division. I tell students to put lines between their columns to make sure they don't get confused when they're doing their work. So let's get started. So the first thing we're going to do is try to start dividing from the left side of the dividend. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to start by dividing 6. Can 21 go into 6? No, it can't. So instead, what we're going to do is we're going to try to go into 66. Can 21 go into 66? Well, the answer is yes. But the question is, how many times can that happen? Well, it looks to me like 21, that might go about 3 times. So let's try that in our work area. So we'll do 21. Times 3. 3 times 1 is 3. And 3 times 2 is 6. That's perfect. That's just under 66. So now what we'll do is we'll take this number 3 and we'll put it up here. Because as we saw, 21 times 3 gives us 63. And we'll write that here. So we've already done our division by seeing how many times 21 can go into 66. We did our multiplication to find out how many times. And now what we have to do is subtract. So we'll subtract 66 minus 63. And 6 minus 3 is 3. And the last step is B. And remember, the B stands for bring down. And what we're bringing down is the number in our very next column. So we'll bring down our 5 and place it right next to 3. So now we'll go back and repeat the process. So now we have to divide again. But what are we dividing? The 3? No, we're dividing the whole thing, 35. And how many times can 21 go into 35 without going over? Well, I think 2 times would be too many. But let's do some work to make sure that's the case. So we've got 21 times 2. 2 times 1 is 2. And 2 times 2 is 4. 42 is way higher than 35, so that's not going to work. So we'll just use 1. And 1 times 21 is 21. We did our division by going into 35. We did a multiplication to find the 1. And 1 times 21 was 21. Now we're at S, which means we have to subtract. So I'll put a minus sign and then subtract. 5 minus 1 is 4. And 3 minus 2 is 1. Now we're at B, which means to bring down. But what are we bringing down? Well, we're bringing down the number in the next column to the right. So we're going to bring down this 7. Since we finished bringing down, now we go back to division. But what are we dividing now? Are we dividing 1? Are we dividing 4? Are we dividing 14? Nuh-uh. We're dividing everything after we brought that number down, which means, since we brought down our 7, we're dividing all of this, 147. Now that's a big number. How many times do you think 21 can go into 147? Let's try 21 times 5. 21 times 5. 5 times 1 is 5. 5 times 2 is 10. And that's 105. We can definitely go a little bit higher. Let's try 21 times 7. 21 times 7. 7 times 1 is 7. 7 times 2 is 14. Perfection! We got it! 147. So that means we'll put this 7 right up top here, because 7 times 21 is 147, and we'll write that here. So we've done our division, we've done our multiplication over here. Now we have to subtract. So we'll subtract 147 minus 147, and that's going to give us 0. This is important here, because when our remainder is 0, and there's nothing else to bring down, that means we're officially done. So our final answer is 317. You could also say the quotient of 6,657 and 21 is 317.